Thank you, Mr. Moderator. I'm Henrik Clausen speaking on behalf of Wiener Akademikerbund. I will talk about freedom of assembly. And let me start with our recommendations. We recommend that trying to destroy public events of others should itself be a punishable offense. That violent groups plotting attacks on public events be monitored by the authorities, and that the OSCE Freedom of Assembly guidelines be amended to not permit counter-demonstrations near the main demonstrations, for this tends to permit clashes. Then we see two positive examples. In Russia, a proposed pension reform led to widespread and well-organized public protest, and the reform was subsequently rejected in the parliament. This is how freedom of assembly works in a sound democracy. In June this year, we held a public rally in Vienna, Austria, for traditional family values. Thanks to good policing, the Antifa black shirts who usually would try to attack us were not seen, and the few hecklers were dealt with properly. This is good policing. This is good for freedom of assembly. In Germany, however, things are still challenging. For a decade, conservative, constitution-friendly groups have routinely been assaulted by extremists verbally and physically. This does not live up to proper standards for freedom of assembly. Most recently in Chemnitz in Germany, a mourning parade for crime victims, a parade organized by the political party Alternative für Deutschland, were falsely accused of sympathy for National Socialism. Considering the evil nature of this ideology, such accusations should not be taken seriously, but they were. Suddenly, East Germans at last were accused of all kinds of evil simply for voicing their dissatisfaction with the neglect, crime and poverty. Fortunately, due to citizen journalism and RT, and I want to specifically thank RT for elaborate coverage, it was easy to see that the accusations were unfounded. Citizens are unhappy with the developments and want to be taken seriously. Conservative activists in Germany are upset about, are so used to being lying about that they coined the phrase Lügenpresse about it. But while the press technically has the right to lie, government officials have a professional obligation to see through such lies. We expect our governments to be honest and impartial on such matters in the future. Thank you.